Shalom, Ras Tefri Salamta. All right, you know, welcome to all that accompany us this day to day. But we just got to put out this emergency message. It's you know, be careful. And this goes to all Ras Tefri, even all those that just, you know, accompany us randomly, you know, all seekers of truth, lovers of truth, and even those that are just curious, even those that are that kind of, even if they got, you know, wicked intents and just seek to take from Rastafari that which they are able to, you know, even them, you know, we wish all people good, because you come across Rastafari, you come across truth, and we guarantee your life will be changed and for the good, regardless of what your intent is. So yeah, we'd like to give this warning to every individual out there, you know, regardless, four corners of the earth, you know, this is for all the eye. You owe it to yourselves, you know, whether you be of, you know, you be seeking wickedness, that can change, you know. We have hope. We have hope for humanity. That's all we know. Rastafari only knows our God and Father, creator of all that is good, and his son, Jesus, our Father, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, being good. No, let us correct that. Being very good, creating all that is good. And so Rastafari do not accept, understand, overstand, or even, you know, even consider anything else but good. And so yeah, take this as a very important message, warning to all. We wish the best to all. Be careful, you know, with what kind of information you accept as truth. You know, don't be quick to make a decision. You've got the rest of your lives, and if you're Rastafari, then you have all eternity. But you know, don't jump to conclusions. You know, you owe it to yourselves. We owe it to ourselves. The human community owes it to ourselves. As a matter of fact, the human community is longing for us to take care of that which is ours. And so let us not be careless. Let us not fall victims to errors in reasoning, fallacies in logic. Let us, you know, pay careful attention to what people putting out information are saying, you know, and look it up for yourself. Due diligence in searching it out, seeking it out. Find different opinions, you know, find out what they say about it, most importantly, what you know about it. And you know, organize yourselves and come to a conclusion in which you are, without a reasonable doubt, sure that you are, with no doubt, sure that what you are, in fact, receiving is 100% true. And so that's all we seek to say, you know, because many different kinds of information in many different kinds of formats and ways and manners, shapes and forms, you know, being put out. And so just be careful, you know, because some of it is false, some of it is true. And don't be discouraged, because a lot of it is false. For inevitably, you know, even the false evidence is only serving its purpose to manifest and make, you know, and make come true the will of the Father. You know, we need some of that false information out there to put alongside the true and kind of like, see, this is true. Just read this, and you know, you'll agree. And so basically what we meant by that not too clear example is that all information, regardless if it be negative, demonic, satanic, you know, whatever, it's all good, because it's all eventually and unavoidably and inevitably, ultimately, it serves for the purpose of the will of Vindac Father and His Christ, Yetta Jesus. And so don't be scared, don't be discouraged. As a matter of fact, we learn a lot from some of that false information. But you know, meditate upon it. And the only thing that we need to do to become great, like researchers, is to be able to cast away, you know, what is false. So, I mean, just be careful, basically, is what we're trying to say, because appearances are deceiving. You know, Satan, the devil himself, the slanderer, kind of, he shines in light, and so he's got that ability to allure people into that trap and kind of just go with the flow. And so he knows how to stimulate emotions and kind of like get your mind all in tangled up and kind of just accept what it is that someone is saying, because he's got the right brand shirt on, or he looks really, really nice or ignorant, we mean, or he talks a certain way. So, or the video presentation is well edited. You know, be careful for that. You know, let us not fall victims to errors in reasoning and fallacies in logic. Now, the reason we make mention, first of all, because it is necessary, and we have to value ourselves. We have to value the human community, and it is not fair that some of us fall victim for lack of care, you know, for being careless and for not being careful. So, we would like nothing else but to receive everyone in the kingdom of Jah Rastafari, but unfortunately, because of slanders and some of those that put out this false information, and also we have to make mention that it also takes the individual that is careless and just jumps to conclusions to jump on the bandwagon. It takes two, one putting out the lies and one not being careful and not seeking it out for himself. Now, we kind of went off with that, and basically here's what's happening. We responded to a video uploaded by Omar Tabaija. The video is called The True Order of Rastafari, and there is nothing true about that video. And we responded to the video. As a matter of fact, we responded in such a way that we were not going to go beyond that which evidence proved and allowed for us to go. Evidence that I personally had come across only, in rightful judgment, it kind of like, it only allowed for us to go to a certain level. But, after speaking with the brother, we checked out his YouTube channel page, and we are referring to Omar Tabaija. And, situation's way worse than we thought, we were kind of like being not too strict, not too tough on him, but nah, definitely demonic activity taking place. The individual is definitely held captive. Worst thing about it is he has no idea, and it's usually the case, right? But nah, this individual is putting out, well, let us correct the previous stated. This demonic entity in the form of Tobija is putting out wicked information that for some reason, not that we were falling victims to it, but I know that because of how he's saying the things and because of the demonic activity behind it, it's not even him. It's Satan, the liar of liars. He knoweth how to deal with the weak minded, and so the stuff that he's presenting, he presents in such a way that ones ignorantly and carelessly would assume that it's so obvious that we won't have to go and check it for ourselves. And so we caught on to that, and so yeah, it's no more, we're not gonna cut him no slack, because yeah, we need to do away with such individuals. And we give thanks and praises to I and I, God and Father, Kedamawi Kaila Shilasianus Christ Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, because this is a great opportunity for Rastafari. You see? Not everything is good in Rastafari, so let us take advantage of this opportunity and due diligence and overcome, there seems to be some darkness along the way, so let us shine light. Let us do what Rastafari do and shine the light of Geta Yesus upon them dark. And if the darkness comprehended it not, then, well, honestly, Abba do away with them. But definitely, even these situations are serving the purpose, the ultimate and inevitable purpose of our God and Father. It's a test for some, But it's not fair. It's not fair for those that are not kind of like up to par, up to the level to be tested by this, but are in fact just allured and drawn in and totally fooled by this. And so, and because of such being fooled in such a way, you know, only John know what results, you know. Some may have been leaning towards Rastafari and they had kind of been pushed away to the side because of this nonsense. Some others may go into some demonic realms and because of this. So yeah, it's an opportunity for us to learn, but it's danger for all the you know, the I'm speaking like if I was like if I was like all learned and stuff like that. Yeah, but we pray and we know that we keep asking that at least we be strong and not fall victim to these kind of tricks. So to those, in some cases probably even more learned than I and thyself, but not right there with the Father in such a relationship where you're kind of like it's easier to be looked after because one is constantly you know in a relationship with the Almighty. And so yeah, and okay, we'll leave that for some other time, but let us just because yeah, I kind of don't want to speak on this matter anymore because there's so much good taking place, but nonetheless it is necessary. You know, just to give some examples, you know, the individuals putting out messages like he made mention that I don't know what he makes mention. That's the thing, you know. I've been trying to put this message out, but see, I mean, and I'm not playing the part, honestly. Rastafari do not understand what is even trying to be said. What is, it's like I'm gonna try the best I can to put to kind of like make this known. It's like they're trying to take away everything from truth, from what at least what Rastafari have been able to receive, and which is we have to admit that it is way more than most individuals worldwide, even you know, even those, even people like that are all experts in the Kabbalah and stuff like that, the tree of life that could they could explain stuff in such a way that you would assume that they know what they're talking about. But nah, they're learned. They have knowledge and information, but because they do not have Geta Jesus and that exemplary life and the spirit, you know, that made manifest because of that pure love between Abba and the Son and stuff like that, because they do not receive that, it's like they can't do nothing with that information. They could talk about it for years and you know, completely amaze us with the knowledge that they possess, but they cannot do anything with it. So let that, you know, and that's another topic right there. Is without the exemplary life, without being able to put the word in action, you're left frozen and you're left, you know, and in a state of arrest, incarcerated, imprisoned, without mobility. And our, you know, the spirit is that mobility. You know, it pushes us, it makes us flow. It allows us to journey, to travel, movement, you know, flexibility. And so let us continue. So there, see, we're trying to avoid how to explain this. He's trying to say that truth, I don't know what he's trying to say, but that somehow what Rastafari is not to be mistaken with supernatural things. And by that, we do not know what he means. Like he says stuff like that come on, like man is made a certain way and nothing else can be but that which man are. And it's not even, I can't even say that he's trying to prove a scientific point, because science would even disagree with what he's saying. Basically, he's trying to put everyone on hold and just shut them down because it's like one example. He Tobia, or what's his name? Omar Tobijah, he made mention that the virgin birth could have never happened because we're humans and we're men, and that the laws of Jah, yeah, we overs that Almighty Abba, that he has laws, right? But and so we overstand how ones would kind of fall victim to this false vain imagination. So he presents the case, yeah, that like man has to have sex or intimate relations and pass the seed over to the female in order for her to get pregnant, become pregnant, stuff like that. So anyone that says that the virgin birth was literal, that it actually happened, is false, and that Rastafari is not about that. Well, how do you explain this? You see, this is where many would kind of be like, oh yeah, that's so true, no need to even look it up. But listen, check this out, how easy that is proven, disproved. Then how do you explain Adam? There was no female, you know? It's like, I think it's easier for Jah to make in this case, and in the only case, Kieta Jesus Christus, be born of a virgin than Adam, because at least there was Mariam, you know? Maria was there. And so I would assume that it's easier, not that anything's hard, for, you know, not that the arm of our Lord and Savior is too short, you know? But so how could you not accept the virgin birth when you accept the beginning of Adam? There was no female. So how do you explain that? It's once we still receive this as, nah, that doesn't even matter. But no, it does matter. It matters a whole lot. And let us go beyond that. If Geta Jesus Christus would have been born of a man, then he would not have been the one to bring salvation, because he would have been born in sin. Man had fallen, and so man was in a state of sin, in a fallen state, and therefore the Almighty, knowing all things, knew that his son, which would S-O-N, which would explain a lot, you know, is, we've seen the Father, he's made manifest, and I am he, you know, and we testify to that. So the Father exists, all right? So I mean, it's pretty clear the virgin birth is totally possible. It's like we've seen God manifest in man in his own creation, and so we know that there is a man, you know, in as God, that can manifest in man. So what's so difficult about, you know, having his spirit impregnate Mariam, you know? And so yeah, it is to be taken literal. It's pretty simple. Anyways, so therefore Geta Jesus Christus was born of the only thing that was pure, of the only matter, of the only person, of the only all that was pure, and that is the Creator, that is very, very good. And so that is why Geta Jesus was born of a virgin, but doesn't have a father. I mean, we know the Father. So you know, think about that. It's pretty simple. And I mean, let us go on to other kind of like examples. He puts the example of that anything that you don't see, that it's not real. Come on, he's trying to convince people that supernatural things don't exist. But then again, what is spiritual? You know, we don't see spiritual things. And we know that they exist. So this individual doesn't even know what he's saying. The thing is that many out there don't know what they're receiving and don't do diligence to seek it out. You see, that's the problem. But Omar Tobijah's got nothing. I mean, he's not one sentence agrees with the one that he made mention prior to that one. It's like, I don't see the breath that I that I take in, but I breathe, you know? I don't even tell myself to breathe, but I do. So, I mean, it's there's so many different ways to just discredit and abandon some of the worst ideas that we've heard yet. But so we are not, according to Omar Tabaja, we are not to believe in anything that we can't see. So basically, he's asking us to give up our faith. Because what is faith? We have faith in that which most of it at one, well, mostly in the beginning, most of it is not visible. And as a matter of fact, it's like, most of it is not visible all the time. But in to some of us that are growing, it becomes hard to accept that faith is not visible, because we do see it. See, it's different, man. This is so hard. It's it's difficult to explain how faith is stuff that you can't see. But you know, for people starting out, you have to tell them, yeah, God is real, and they have to kind of just go with it without seeing anything. But you know, people stick around, you know, because it gets to the point where it's hard to accept that faith are things that you can see, because you see it all the time. It's in every single little, it's in all of creation. For him that created all is in all. But yeah, so let us, you know, let us abandon that idea. I mean, okay, we didn't do that well explaining that. So let us go to hope. What is hope? You know, scripture, we could go to scripture on that one at least. It what is hope? We are told by Paul that we are to hope for those things which are not seen. And excuse that if it's not even Paul, see, like, I mean, I'm not pretending to know everything, okay, yeah, I mean, I shouldn't have said that, but anyways, yeah, I really don't recall if it's Paul or not, but scripture does make mention New Testament. That's all, that's as far as I can go. But New Testament makes mention that, you know, if you hope for those things which are seen, then what need of hope is there? You know, hope, we are to hope for that which is not visible. So Omar Tabaja, what do you say about that? I mean, there's so, I mean, that's it. I mean, I really don't want to deal with well, we don't deal, right? So yeah, so we're done basically. But be careful is what we're trying to say. Be careful, everyone. So many things. I mean, your dad goes to work. I mean, children, your parents go to work, and you don't see that, right? But you have faith that is the case. Is that supernatural? Is that a false? Is that like wrong because we take it literal? Like, are we supposed to think that our parents go to work in a parabolic sense? I mean, that's, you know, that's a lame excuse to be doing whatever it is that you want to do, because by not accepting that which was once not seen but now revealed to eye and eye, then it's like you're just trying to avoid responsibility. You do not want to accept that. It's the same deal with the same situation when people don't want to accept the humanity of Christ, because then that means that they got to get their act together. And it's like that scripture, we've been over this. I mean, check out the videos. It's like 4 or 5 parts. We made mention that scripture where Geta Jesus addresses, in that case, it was John chapter 7, I'm gonna say, and where he says, like, what was it, like, Moses gave you a law and you don't even keep that, and now you seek to kill me. So basically it's like they don't want to see the word in action. It's basically what's going on, you know. So if they keep it to worshiping idols, then guess what, they can make up their own interpretations of what a poster it wants them to do, because the poster will not respond and will not act and will not, it's a poster, it's a picture, it's whatever. And so they're rather just, it's excuses. Excuse I. Yeah, it just gotta. Yeah, it's definitely John chapter 7, and we were referring to verse 19. Did not Moses give you the law, and yet none of you keepeth the law? Why go ye about to kill me? And I gotta say it again. Here's the ignorance of the people. The people answered and said, "Thou hast the devil who goeth about to kill thee?" See, that's what we're trying to avoid. It's like, what? Yeah, so basically, that's just showing the ignorance of the people. So, basically, be careful. We apologize that this message got way long. Stay tuned for the good news. Shalom, Rastafari.